Welcome back to Liberal Live. First, congratulations to the Canadian men's hockey team. Terrific game, terrific experience in Sochi. We have a special guest with us today, John Zericelli, who is the Secretary General for the convention. And we need your thoughts and impressions today.
Well, this has been a fantastic convention. It's been an exciting time. Isn't it an exciting time to be a Liberal?
Definitely. The energy in the room is amazing.
There's energy joy.
In the room is fantastic. Fantastic. You know, so my responsibility is to organize the convention. And in that role, I have brought together amazing panelists. But I want to thank you, the online community. You guys have come out to support this convention in a number of ways. And I just want to say it's been fantastic. We appreciate it. That's why we do it. Liberal Live has done an amazing job. And our online hosts have been amazing.
Thank you.
You guys have been fantastic.
Amateurs trying to do a professional
job. amateurs.
But really, I want to thank the over 500 volunteers who have come out to support the party, who have worked tirelessly to put together the backdrop,
sure.
The chairs, the tables, being there to greet the delegates day in and day out. It's been fantastic. We couldn't do this without the volunteers, and we couldn't do it without you, frankly. So, frankly, my impressions are at this point that it's been a fantastic convention. There's been a lot of excitement, a lot of energy, I think we've really done a great job here.
Can we throw it back, right back at you? Thank you for the work that
for
you've
sure.
done.
Thank you.
You're looking a little more rested this morning, but
amazing
yesterday
rested.
You were on all day, and it's been a lot of work.
Yeah, it has been.
It has been positive, but it's been a lot of work. So thank you for all of that.
So, well, let me say that the conventions don't come together. It's taken us about 6 months to pull this together, you know, it's been fantastic, the amount of support that we've had from our plenary speakers. To the support for the party, it's just been a fantastic, fantastic event. So.
I thought the mixture, pour notre audience francophone, ce qu'on disait à John, d'abord, on le félicitait pour un congrès qui a été magnifique. Je pense que la diversité des panélistes qu'on a eu, des experts, nos amis américains qui sont venus nous parler de la façon dont ils font leur convention, dont ils font leur campagne, c'était rafraîchissant. Vous aviez, John, you had the right mixture, I think, of experts, of people from the party, of new people. It was really about building the team, building the plan. And I feel personally we've achieved that. What were the highlights of this convention for you?
Well, first of all, the speeches of Justin were obviously a key highlight. We needed him to show the party that we are renewed, that we're building the team and building the plan. And so the highlights for me were our fantastic co-chairs. How amazing were they? They were so
great.
Energized. So energized.
Charismatic.
Charismatic, but in their own right, very, very impressive people, like you. Very, very impressive in their own right. And so the highlights for the convention for me were, obviously, Justin on Thursday was fantastic. We took some shots at Harper, which, you know, is always a good thing. On Friday, we heard from General Andrew Leslie, who is a key player on Justin's team. On Saturday, it was about Bill Morneau, Jody Wilson-Rebold, Jim Carr, and, of course, Justin. So, you know, it was very impressive. We heard from them with respect to the plan on the economy, building towards a middle-class economic policy that will be there to help and grow the middle class. And that's what we need right now.
Sure.
Can I talk about Liberal Live for a minute?
Of course.
I want to thank you for that and for supporting this process, because it's been very engaging. Mm-hmm. And the opportunity that we've had to interview a lot of the guests you've just mentioned would come here and then have a little bit more of an intimate discussion with the online audience. There were comments coming through Twitter, comments coming through our community desk, and they've done a fantastic job as well, André and Christine and Vinay, because it's been engaging, I think, over 25,000 people over the course of this weekend.
Well, I was just about to say that.
Okay.
The numbers, you're taking my clip line.
Sorry, John, that's not what a host is supposed to do. I'm failing.
You know, this is all live.
Go ahead, John.
In fairness, this Liberal Live has been a huge and tremendous success. Over 25,000 unique views. It's amazing. And so, you know, what you have done here this weekend has been impressive. But it's more because the viewers have wanted to see what's going on. They're interested about Justin. They're interested in our party. And that's what we really like. And so, you know, we get that it is expensive to come to Montreal. We know that. You know, especially if you're in the Northwest Territories, the Yukon, sure. British Columbia. It's very difficult to get here. And so we know that. And so that's why we, as a party, support this. Because we want people to know what we're doing. We want people to see Justin, we want people to engage, have a dialogue with us, because that's the only way that this country is going to get better. Right now, Stephen Harper is trying to stifle debate. He is trying to stop people from voting. And we as a Liberal Party and as people who are interested in the Liberal Party have to say, no, actually, we want to have a debate. We want to have a discussion about where this country needs to go. And that's why, that's one of the reasons why we've done this on Liberal Live. I also want to say one other thing. I was talking to a number of people in the media the other day, and the point that I made to them is that there's a very different stand on, between us and the Conservatives on media. Most of our convention, almost 95% of our convention, was open to media coverage.
Sure.
And there's a reason for that. The Conservatives, you know how much of their convention was open? Two things. Stephen Harper's speech and the speech of their chief fundraiser. That was it. That was the only thing that was open to media. And you know what? This convention, we opened up most of the convention to media coverage, and the reason for that is because we believe that the media are part of the democratic process. Wow. And frankly, you know, that's a very different view. We take a different view of that than the Conservatives.
I'd say, you know, on behalf of the thousands of Canadians which have listened to us over the last 4 days from coast to coast to coast, I'd say thank you. Thank you for believing in open democracy. Thank you for believing in dialogue. Thank you for believing in us. And certainly, it's these people, our online audience, with our community, which have been engaging. We wanted to bring the convention to the people, yes. And thank you for believing in that, because you allowed us to be here and make that happen for the thousands of people.
Well,
so thank you for that.
No, well, thank you, and thank you for having me today. I really
merci
appreciate
beaucoup,
it.
John. Merci. Merci.